Hi dear students, I welcome all the 11th standard students to this YouTube channel. Today onwards, we are going to learn our English lessons. Now, we are going to start with the first prose in the English textbook. The name of the story is The Portrait of a Lady, written by Khushwant Singh. The Portrait of a Lady, written by Khushwant Singh. Do you know what is a portrait? A portrait is a photo or a picture or a drawing. Here, in this story, the author Khushwant Singh picturizes his grandmother through his words. Or, in this story, Khushwant Singh describes his grandmother very beautifully through his story. The lady in the title name, The Portrait of a Lady, is his grandmother, Khushwant Singh's grandmother. Before starting the lesson, I want to ask you one question. Do you have grandparents at your home? How do they look? Or what do they do? You may have grandparents at your home. They look very old and wrinkled, and sometimes they hold a stick in their hand to support them, right? Here, in this story, The Portrait of a Lady, we are going to meet Khushwant Singh's grandmother. This story brings out the bond of relationship between the author and his loving grandmother. There was a good relationship between the author Khushwant Singh and his grandmother. Here, in the first paragraph, Khushwant Singh beautifully picturizes his grandmother. He says that, like everybody's grandmother, his grandmother also is very old and wrinkled for the 20 years he had known. He knows his grandmother for the past 20 years and she had been the same. She is very old and wrinkled. Have you seen wrinkles on the faces of grandparents? Look at the picture. Here, and one more thing. He heard from his neighbors and other people that his grandmother was once very young and pretty and she had a husband. It was unbelievable for Khushwant Singh that once his grandmother was young and pretty and even she had a husband. Now he is going to tell about his grandfather. There is a picture of his grandfather above the mantelpiece near in the living room or drawing room. Mantelpiece is a shelf over the fireplace. Look at the picture. You can understand from the picture. The grandfather wore a big turban and loose fitting clothes. He had long white beard covered the best part of his chest. He looked at least 100 years old. He looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. He was that much old. He looked 100 years old. After giving a brief description about his grandfather, Khushwant Singh again talks about his grandmother. Khushwant Singh is not able to think or even imagine his grandmother being pretty and young once in her life. His grandmother used to tell him the games she used to play in her childhood days with her friends. To him, his grandmother playing games as a child seemed quite absurd or illogical. He can't even imagine his grandmother as a young girl playing games with her friends. His grandmother had always been short and fat and slightly bent. She hobbled about the house with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop and the other telling the beads of her rosary. and her lips continuously or constantly moved in inaudible prayer. She was beautiful. Look at the picture. Have you seen? Yes, that lady was walking unsteadily. Hobbled means walked unsteadily in the house with one hand resting on her waist. She is supporting herself with one hand on her waist and the other hand telling the beads of her rosary. She is praying using the beads of her rosary, and her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayer, and she was praying something. We are not able to listen to what she was praying. Yes, she was very beautiful. In the next paragraph onwards, we can see the good bond of relationship between Kushwant Singh and his grandmother. Kushwant Singh says that his grandmother and he were good friends. When his parents went to city, he was left with his grandmother in the village. His parents went to city for job, so he was left with his grandmother in the village. His grandmother used to wake him up in the morning and get him ready for school. She said her morning prayer in a monotonous sing-song while she dressed him up, and she hoped that he would listen and learn the morning prayer by heart. He listened the morning prayer of his grandmother and he loved her voice. In the morning for breakfast, she made chapatis for him with a little butter and sugar spread on it. Together they went to school. While going to school, she carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. Do you know why his grandmother also accompanied him to the school? In olden days, schools were attached to the temples. She used to sit in the temple near the school and she read the scriptures and she prayed sitting there. Each day after completing the school hours, together they went back to home. While going back to home, they threw the chapatis for the village dogs. The village dogs were growling and fighting with each other for the chapati. When Kushwant Singh's parents were comfortably settled in the city, Kushwant Singh and his grandmother also went to the city to live there in the city. That was a turning point in their friendship. Now, in the city, he joined in an English medium school. He went alone to the school. His grandmother didn't accompany him to the school, and there were no street dogs to be fed by him or his grandmother. His grandmother took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard of their new city house. Years rolled by. Even though Kushwant Singh and his grandmother staying in the same house, they saw less of each other and they talked also very less. Sometimes his grandmother asked him about the teaching in the city school or the English school. He told her that they were learning science, maths and English in the school. But she was distressed or disappointed that there was no teaching about God and scriptures. Scriptures means holy books in the city school. In the village school, they used to learn about God and scriptures. When Kushwant Singh went to the university for higher studies, he was given a room of his own. He occupied a room for himself and the common link of friendship between the grandmother and the author was damaged. His grandmother started to spin the wheel from sunrise to sunset to make herself engaged. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while to feed the sparrows. She started to feed the sparrows small birds that came to their veranda in the afternoon. The small sparrows came and sat on her legs, others on her shoulders, some even sat on her head. She smiled, but never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day for her. When Khushwant Singh decided to go abroad for further studies, he was sure his grandmother would be upset. But she was not even sentimental. She came to the railway station to see him off, and her lips moved in prayer. Her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. She silently kissed him on his forehead. After 5 years, Khushwant Singh came back home. But there was no change in his grandmother. She still continued her prayer and she was feeding the sparrows in the courtyard. But on the day of his arrival, there was a sudden change in his grandmother. She stopped her prayer and she collected the neighborhood women and an old drum. She started to sing and play the drum. She played it for a long time. Everyone compelled her to stop playing the drum and singing for a long time. But she continued. In the next morning, she was taken ill. The doctor said that it was a mild fever. But his grandmother thought differently. She was sure that her end was near. So she stopped talking to others and she started to pray again. And after some time, her body became pale and she was dead. They were making arrangements for the grandmother's burial or cremation. At that time, in the evening, there were thousands of sparrows scattered on the floor near the grandmother's dead body. The sparrows were very silent. They were sitting very silently. Seeing the sparrows, everyone felt sorry for the birds. And Khushwant Singh's mother fetched a few breadcrumbs for the sparrows. But the sparrows didn't take any notice of the breadcrumbs. They didn't take the breadcrumbs. When the grandmother's body was taken for cremation, the sparrows also flew away from that place very quietly. Next morning, the sweeper swept the breadcrumbs into the dustbin. What did you understand from this? The final paragraph. We can understand that there was a close bond of relationship between the sparrows and the grandmother. Because of that only, the sparrows didn't take the breadcrumbs from others. Even though others threw breadcrumbs for them, the sparrows were not ready to take the breadcrumbs. And from this story, we can understand that the grandmother was eagerly waiting for the return of her grandson, Khushwant Singh. And on the day of his arrival itself, she passed away. She left this world. And we can also understand that animals and birds are also lovable creatures. If we love them, if we spend time for the animals and birds, they return love to us. Here ends the story, The Portrait of a Lady. Hope you enjoyed the story. Thank you.